First of all, what is ingress? Ingress is an API object used to expose services outside of Kubernetes, usually via HTTP and HTTPS protocols. You can expose service to the internet using the public load balancer, or you may choose to expose it only internally within your VPC. If you simply create an ingress object in your Kubernetes cluster, it won't do anything for you until you have ingress controller. There are many different ingress controllers available. One of the most commonly used and reliable is the Nginx ingress controller. Typically, you install it using a deployment object and create a service of type load balancer. The biggest benefit of using the Nginx ingress controller and ingress in general is that you can share a single load balancer across all your applications that you want to expose. When you create ingress, you need to specify what ingress controller will be used to fulfill the request. In the past, it was done using Kubernetes annotation, but after ingress API transitioned from beta to V1, you would use ingress class field instead. Like many Kubernetes applications, Nginx Ingress Controller exposes Prometheus metrics. You can create Grafana dashboard to monitor the latency, number of requests, and availability of the service using just Nginx metrics out of the box. If you wish, you can also deploy Nginx Admission webhook that can validate the custom configuration on the ingress level and notify you if the configuration is not valid before you even apply it. It can save you a lot of time when you're trying to debug your ingress. I'll give you a few examples of how you can use it. You can use a simple fanout. A fanout configuration routes traffic from a single IP address to more than one Kubernetes service based on the HTTP URI being requested. You can decide to use name-based virtual hosting. This will allow to route traffic based on the host names specified in the ingress. In case you want to secure your endpoint with HTTPS, you would need to deploy a cert manager. Then you would typically create a Let's Encrypt issuer that can be used on the ingress object to automatically obtain the certificate and renew it as well. Sometimes you need to share the same load balancer with other services, for example, Postgres database. You can use Nginx TCP or UDP service to expose those types of services as well. To do that, you would create a config map with a mapping and add additional flag to the Nginx Ingress Controller. If you want to learn more about Nginx Ingress Controller, I have a full tutorial in which I cover how to deploy, monitor, and all of the examples above.